So I think we have stopped considering this particular circuit yesterday. Okay, so we looked at two level clippers, and more or less we have considered three circuits. Okay, and this might be the last circuit, and we used to say that this circuit may not be very much helpful to us in practice. So let us see that why this is not so very much helpful for us. So what is the difference when compared to the other three circuits? For this particular circuit is, here also we are having the same V reference VR1 and VR2, but nevertheless here V reference VR1 is positive and V reference VR2 is negative. So that means in this particular case my VR1 is greater than VR2. In all the other three cases we found out that VR2 is greater than VR1, but unlike that here we have considered in such a way that my VR1 is greater than VR2. So we will be saying that this circuit is not that effective to be used in practice. So let us see why it is so. Okay. So analysis of the circuit in the sense that you need to find the output for the entire input range. Let us consider the input signal is a sinusoidal input signal. When the sinusoidal input signal is varying from minus infinity to infinity, for all that entire input range, we need to find out the output voltage. Okay. So that is what is analysis means. Okay, analysis means given input, you are asked to find the output for the circuit. Okay, so let me consider my input Vi. Okay, let me consider my input, which is varying from minus infinity to the plus infinity. What sort of input that we are considering? Sinusoidal input. Okay, so assume that it is varying from minus infinity to plus infinity, and my zero may be somewhere here. If I ask you to locate your VR1 and VR2, as VR1 is positive, I may locate my VR1 somewhere here. Okay. When I locate my VR2 on the x-axis, I can locate my VR2 somewhere here because VR2 is negative in this case. Okay. So far, VR2 is greater than VR1, but for this particular circuit, VR1 is greater than VR2. Okay. So in analyzing my circuit, in finding my output for the entire input range from minus infinity to infinity, what are all the three regions that I'll be splitting my entire input range Vi? That is from minus infinity to VR2. You can see here, from minus infinity to VRT is the one region, and from VR2 to VR1, okay, VR2 to VR1, and lastly it is from VR1 to infinity. Okay, and lastly I can consider the interval as VR1 to infinity. Okay, right, fine. So let us consider the first interval. So within the first interval we are likely to find out what are the states of our diodes, and accordingly we will be trying to find out what is our output is. Okay. Right. So when my Vi is less than VR2, when my Vi is less than VR2, okay, what do you say about your diode, status of the diode D2, for example? My VR2 is tied to the N terminal of my D2. Okay, my VR2 is tied to the N terminal of my D2, and my P terminal of the D2 is tied to the Vi. When my Vi is less than VR2, that means my P side of my D2 is less than my N side of my D2. Whenever my potential at P side is less than the potential at N side, what do I say about my diode D2? Diode D2 off. Is said to be in the off state. Okay. I know that when will be my diode is going to be either in the on state or in the off state. For my diode to be in the on state, my P side potential should be more than the N side potential. For my diode to be in the off state, my P side potential should be less than the potential at the N side. Okay. So as my P side potential, which is tied to the V, is less than VR, which is tied to the N side of my D2, D2 is said to be off. Okay. So when D2 is set to be off, you replace your D2 with the open circuit, okay? And your P side of your D1 is tied to VR1, and your N side of the D1 is tied to your input, okay? So when my VI is less than VR2, is it not that my VI is less than VR1 also, because my VR1 is greater than VR2, is it not? So my input is at most less than VR2, is it not that my input is less than VR1 also? So when my input, which is tied to the N side of my D1, is less than my input, my P side terminal, which is VR1, okay? So that means my N side potential of D1, okay, is less than my P side potential of D1. Then I can say that my diode D1 is said to be in the on state, okay? So with my diode D1 in the on state and D2 in the off state, what do I say about my output voltage? I'll say that my output voltage, this is open circuit, okay, you remove, this is the short circuit. So when I replace with short circuit, my voltage in between these two nodes is given by VR1, okay. So my output is being given by VR1 itself. Is this okay so far? Okay, so within this region, my diode D2 is off and D1 is on. Whenever D1 is on and D2 is off, my output is being given by VR1, right. Now let us consider the interval VR2 to VR1. Okay. Now let us consider the interval VR2 to VR1. Okay. So with VI is greater than VR2. Okay. With VI is greater than VR2. VI is tied to P terminal of your D2. And VR2 is tied to the N terminal of your D2. When VI is greater than VR2, okay, that means my P side of my D2 is more than my N side of my D2. That means my D2 is going to be in the on state. Okay, my D2 is going to be in the on state. With my D2 in the on state, what is that I can write? With my D2 in the on state, what is that I can write? I can write that my VR2 is equal to my minus VD1 plus VR1. Okay, right? So I'll write that my VR2 is equal to minus VD1 plus VR1, from which VD1 is equal to VR1 minus VR2. Okay, as my VR1 is greater than VR2, what is my VD1 is? VD1 is positive. Yes or no? VD1 is positive. Whenever my voltage, okay, whenever my voltage is positive, that is applied across the diode, I say that my diode is in the on state, okay? My D1 is also going to be in the on state, right? But is it valid, okay? Is both the diodes are being on state, what is my output is being given by? This is on state means short circuited, this is on state means short circuited. What is your output is? Which is an invalid, invalid. Why invalid? Because this short circuit means from here to here it is VR1. Short circuit means from here to here it is VR2. And saying that VR1 and VR2 is not equal, it is absurd. Any two elements which are in shunt, they are supposed to have the same voltage. Okay. Otherwise, it is not at all acceptable. Yes or no? Right? So that is why both the diodes are in the on state is not acceptable. And this particular situation is arising. Okay. This particular situation is arising only when the condition that your input is greater than VR2 and less than VR1. So you have to ensure that your input should not be applied in such a way that your VI is in between VR2 and VR1. Okay. Then when we consider the last interval, okay, when we consider the last interval, what is that I can say? Suppose if this is the interval which is saying that you should not use your input in such a way that it is in between VR2 and VR1. Okay, I will not be using that. But what happens for the third interval, that VR1 to infinity. Okay, so from minus infinity to VR2, VR2 to VR1, and VR1 to infinity. So this is the third interval. So when my VI is greater than VR1, okay, VI is tied to the N side of your D1, VR1 is tied to the P side of your D1. When my VI is greater than, that means the N side potential of D1 is greater than the P side potential of your D1, what do you say about your D1? D1 is said to be in the off state. Okay, D1 is said to be in the off state, right? So when my VI is greater than VR1, is it not that my VI is greater than VR2 also? VI is greater than VR1, as VR1 is greater than VR2, When once vi is greater than vr1, vi is greater than vr2 also. Okay, so I am taking the input values which are greater than this, then they are automatically greater than this vr2. When my vi is greater than vr2, okay, vi is tied to your p side of your d2, vr2 is tied to your n side of your d2. So whenever my vi is greater than vr2, okay, then my d2 is said to be in the on state. Okay, because P side potential of D2 is greater than N side potential of the D2. So D2 is said to be in the on state. With the D1 in the off state and D2 in the on state, what is my output is being given by? My output is being given by VR2. Okay, my output is being given by VR2. Okay. So if you want to use this circuit, okay, in a to be functioning properly, can I apply my input in between VR2 and VR1? No. It is not allowed, because that is the region of my input signal where it is violating the actual rules, basic rules. That is, no two elements in the shunt can have different voltages. Okay, so if any two elements are in shunt, they can have the same voltage only. But in the region, if your input signal is in the region in between VR2 to VR1, then it is violating the rules. So you should not give the input in the range of VR2 to VR1. When you are not allowed to give the input in between VR2 to VR1, and how does that circuit is being used? The circuit is being used or being acting as something like a one level clipper only, okay, where your output is either equal to the VR1 or either equal to the VR2. Okay, then what is the use of using this as a two level clipper? So no use. So that is why this is not being used in practice. Okay, the arrangement itself, okay, why does that situation is arising? That mode, both my diodes are being in the on state. Why does that situation is arising? Because when once this diode is on, okay, this diode is also going to become on because of your choice of making your VR1 is more than my VR2. Unlike that, if you ensure that your VR2 is more than your VR1, then both diodes being on is not going to exist, and it will not violate that any two voltage sources that are in shunt may be having the different voltages will not exist. Okay, so that is why though we can have this type of circuit also, but it is not used in practice. Okay, so for this reason, this circuit is not being used in practice. Okay, so the question is, determine the range of input signal for which my output is same as the input. Can anyone tell me the answer? The question is, determine the range of input for which the output is same as the input.
Minus 1 to 2.
Minus 1 to 2. Okay. Okay. Right. In fact, the gate question is not as it is. Okay. In the gate question, it is mentioned that the diodes are not ideal. Okay. What you said is right. That my input range in between minus 1 to 2, the output is same as the input is right. Okay. But the question is, assume that the diodes are not ideal and the drop across the diodes, okay, forward voltage drop, okay, forward voltage drop across the diodes, okay, across D1 and D2. Is 0.7. Okay, he is 0.7. This is what is the question is. Okay, so this diode drop is being given means that is a model coming under is a constant voltage drop model. Okay, constant voltage drop model. Right, so that means you are asked to use the constant voltage drop model indirectly. Right, what is this constant voltage drop model means? It is a practical diode, no more an ideal diode. Ideal diode means what? Ideal diode means what? Positive voltage, 0 volts is enough for making your diode on. Okay, practical diode means what? A minimum of 0.7 volts at least is required to be applied across your diode, positive, negative, okay? Apply a voltage at least 0.7 volts across your diode, then only it is going to be on. That is what is a practical diode is. That is what is given in the question is. They consider forward voltage drop across D1 and D2 is 0.7. Okay, that means for the diodes to conduct, the minimum voltage that should appear across the diode is 0.7 volts. So how do I use this model? Okay, so whenever my diode is here, I'll be replacing my diode with a model called constant voltage drop model, which is representing like this. Now this is going to be an ideal diode. Okay, now this is going to be an ideal diode. You all know very well what is the ideal diode. Okay, so this diode is now going to be an ideal diode, so that this battery is nothing but your V gamma. V gamma is nothing but the forward voltage drop of the diode. Okay, so when we are likely to use this constant voltage drop model, we need to replace our diode with an ideal diode followed by a voltage source. Okay, and this voltage source is nothing but your 0.7 volts, that is given in the question. Okay, so for silicon it is roughly about 0.7 volts, right? Okay, so when I replace my diode with this particular model, okay, how it is going to happen? What is going to happen? I'll be replacing now. Okay, I'll be replacing both of my diodes with this particular model. Okay, I'll be replacing both of my diodes with this particular model. Okay, this is your 0.7 volts, this is your 0.7 volts. Is the equivalent circuit is okay? What I have done is I have replaced my diode with this model. What is this model? Is constant voltage drop model. Okay, this model is constant voltage drop model, right? So that means now this diode is more or less an ideal diode. Okay, because you have used your forward voltage drop that is required for your diode to be on. Okay, this is also now is going to be your ideal diode because you have included your forward bias voltage, right? See, when we suppose if this diode is an ideal diode, okay, right, under what condition it is going to be forward biased? When a 0 volts or positive voltage is applied across it. But now how much is the voltage that need to be applied for making this diode forward biased? The P side of the diode should be more than the N side of the diode, but what is tied to the N side of the diode? 0.7 volts. That means until my P side of this diode is more than 0.7, this diode will not be on. That is what is the practical diode mean. Okay, so until potential at this side is more than the 0.7, because to the N side of this diode 0.7 has been tied. Okay, so when two sources are in series, okay, if they are in the same polarities, you can add them. Okay, if they are in same polarities, you can add them, right? For example, this is 0.7, okay, this is 0.7, but the polarities are like minus plus, so minus 0.7, and the polarities are plus minus, which is represented with minus 1. See, negative voltage can be represented in two different ways. As this is a positive voltage, no issue at all. Plus minus 2 volts, so 2 volts battery, no issue. Plus minus minus 1 is a minus volt battery. Okay, minus 1 volts representation, you can have it like plus minus and minus 1, writing it as minus 1. Or otherwise, you can write it even something like this. Okay, I'll be representing it as minus plus, then writing it as plus 1 volt. Then also it is minus 1 volt. Okay, so both are being same, right? Both are being same. So when two voltage sources are in series, I can add them with the same polarities. Okay, so this is minus 0.7 and minus 1. So what is the voltage source, equivalent voltage source? I can represent that with a minus 1.7, a minus 1.7. Okay, right? Is this okay? So I can represent this minus 1.7 even something like this, minus plus plus 1.7, both are same. Okay, if I represent with minus plus, then it has to be a positive. If I represent with plus minus, then you are representing a negative number, then it is minus 1.7. Both are being same, no issue. Okay. Okay. So this is my equivalent circuit. And similarly here, when I come in this direction, 0.7 plus 2 volts. So what is the overall voltage source? My overall voltage source is, okay, my overall voltage source is 2.7 volts. Okay, my overall voltage source is 2.7 volts. Okay, my overall voltage source is 2.7 volts. Now this is an ideal diode. Now this is an ideal diode. But now in this case, the reference voltage VR1 is minus 1.7. In this case, the reference voltage VR2 is 2.7. Now if I ask you to tell me what is the input range or which your output is going to be same as the input, what is your input range is?
Minus 1.7 to 2.7
is the input range or which your output is same as the input. Okay. So, but we are not interested in an answer like what is the input range for which your output is same as the input. Our interest is to draw the output response. Okay, for the input signal, let us say that my input signal is some 10 sine omega t. Let us be very practical. Okay, then we will plug in some numerals also. Then we will be understanding in a much more better way. Okay, our task is what? To draw the output response. Okay, to draw the output response for taken input signal. Okay, let us consider an input signal as some 10 sine omega t. Okay, let us consider an input signal 10 sine omega t, and then you need to draw the output response. Okay, so I'll be considering my input signal like this. Okay, I'll be considering my input signal like this. I'll be considering my input signal like this. This is my input Vi of t. Okay, this is my input Vi of t. Okay, so let this be the input. Okay, so the dotted curve is representing our input. The dotted curve is representing our input. Let this be a 10 volts. Okay, let this be a minus 10 volts. Okay, is this okay? So for this input signal, we'll try to draw the output response. Okay, right. For example, let us start from here. Please do understand. Okay, please do understand carefully. If you have understood this problem where some numerals are given, okay. So far we have considered very generally, okay. So that may be somewhat easier for you to understand, but when once the numerals are being given, understanding is very important, okay. So consider now the input signal whose peak to peak is given as minus 10 to plus 10. You are asked to draw the output response, okay. You are asked to draw the output response, okay. So let me consider a positive half cycle, that is from this side to this side. Okay, positive half cycle. When once I am considering my positive half cycle, what do you say about your status of your diodes D1 and D2? Let us consider that this is D1 and this is D2. If I am considering a positive half cycle, that means either not my input is positive, my input is positive. When my input is positive, what do you say about your D1 and D2? Very important, okay. Understanding that when will be my diode is going to be on or off is what is the catch. And you know that whenever my P side of my diode is more than my N side of my diode, then only it is said to be in the on state. Whenever my N side is more than my P side of my diode, then only it is said to be in the off state. Okay. So if my input is positive, okay, I am considering my positive half cycle means my input is positive. With my input is positive, what do you say about your D1? Irrespective of why? Because to the P side of my D1, a negative is being connected. Okay, to the P side of my D1, a negative is being connected. When once my input is positive, that means N side is more than the P side. Okay, N side is more than the P side. That is why D1 is going to be off as long as your input is positive. Okay, so for my positive half cycle, okay, for my positive half cycle, right? So that is from Vi is greater than 0, okay, that is from Vi is greater than 0, okay, for all my Vi greater than 0, that is positive, okay, my D1 is off, 100%. And what do you say about your D2? Is D2 is off or on, or does it depend on what to say whether it is on or off? My N side of D2 is connected to plus 2.7 volts and my P side is connected to your input. Okay. So, if my input is a positive, when will my diode D2 is going to be in the on state or off state? Okay. When will be my diode D2 is going to be in the on state or off state? When? For my D2 to be in the on state, my P side should be more than the N side, as N side is already tied to 2.7 volts. Until my P side is greater than 2.7 volts, my D2 will not be in the on state. Okay. And what is being tied to your P side of the D2 input? So that means your diode is being on or off is dependent on your input. If your input is less than 2.7, then your D2 is in the off state. Okay. Then your D2 is in the off state. If your P side of your D2 is more than your 2.7, then your D2 is said to be in the on state. Okay. So when I consider, okay, when I consider up to 2.7, that means my Vi is less than 2.7. Okay. My Vi is less than 2.7. That means my P side is less than 2.7. That means my potential at P is less than my potential at N. Thereby my D2 is going to be in the off state. Okay. So in this interval, both D1 is off and D2 is off. Yes or no? Both D1 is off. D1 is off because my input itself is positive. When once N side is tied to the positive, as my P side is tied to negative, 100% this is off. Okay. But my D2 is dependent on what is my input is. If my input is positive, that is okay. But only when my input is greater than 2.7, then only my diode D2 is going to be on. When I consider up to less than 2.7, my D2 is going to be off. When both are off, replace with open circuit, replace with open circuit, then what is your output is given by? No drop across your R, so voltage drop is 0, then my output is same as the input. What is your output? Is output is given by same as the input. Is this okay? Yes or no? Right? Okay. So, I have started from here onwards until my 2.7, okay? Until my 2.7, my output is same as input. What happens if my input is greater than 2.7? What happens if my input is greater than 2.7? Even if it is greater than 2, even if it is greater than 2.7, but once if it is positive, that is enough for my diode D1 to be in the off state itself. Okay. But when once it is greater than 2.7, D2 is going to start conducting. Okay. D2 is going to become on. Okay. So over the interval 2.72, okay, over the interval 2.72 maximum is 10. Yes or no? Over the interval 2.72, 10. Right? So that is in between 2.7 to 10, what is my diode? D1 is off anyway because the input is positive, so diode D1 is off. That is okay. Okay, D1 is off. Right? D1 is off undoubtedly. But what do you say about your D2? As my D2, potential at D2, potential at P of your D2 is more than potential at N side of your D2, my D2 is going to be on. If your D2 is going to be on, okay, if your D2 is going to be on, what do you say about your output? My D2 is on, replace with short circuit, okay. Now they are going to be your ideal diodes because you have already included the drops across the diodes. So when my D2 is being on, replace with short circuit, so what is my output voltage from here to here?
2.7.
So my output is going to be 2.7. Okay. My output is going to be 2.7. Okay. So let me draw my output response for the first positive half cycle. Okay. Let me draw the output voltage for the first positive half cycle. Okay. So until my input is 0 to 2.7, my output is same as the input. Until my input is 0 to 2.7, let us say that this is 2.7. Okay, let us say that this is 2.7. So until my input is 0 to 2.7, output is same as input. For all my input greater than 2.7 to less than 10, okay, that is from here to here. Okay, from here to here, my input is greater than 2.7 and in between 10. Okay, So what is my output is been given by 2.7 itself. Okay, 2.7 itself. Okay, and from here to here, my input is positive. Okay, so D1 is off, and my input is less than 2.7. When my input is positive and less than 2.7, what is my output is same as the input. So my output is same as the input. Okay, right? Okay. So now let us consider the negative half cycle. Okay, let us consider the negative half cycle. When once my input is negative half cycle means my input is negative. When once my input is negative, okay, when once my input is negative, okay, what do you say about your D2? When once my input is negative, okay, irrespective of what value of your of my input is, if it is negative, what do you say about your D2? Because to the n side of my D2, 2.7 volts has been tied positive. Okay, if my P side is being given a negative, because my input is going to be negative, okay, at most the maximum some voltage that can appear here is negative only. So when my P side of my D2 is negative, when my N side of my D2 is 2.7 volts plus, okay, then my D2 is always going to be off. Okay,
off state.
Okay, so when I am considering my negative half cycle, okay, when I am consider that your VI is less than 0. Okay. So when my VI is less than 0, that means negative. Okay. When once my input is negative, my D2 is off itself. Okay. My D2 is off itself. And what do you say about your D1? When once my VI is negative, D2 is off. Because P side of my D2 is negative, so D2 is off. What do you say about your D1? When will be your D1 is going to be on or off, or it depends on what? As my P side of D1 is tied to minus 1.7 volts. Okay. And my input is negative, when will be my D1 is going to be in the on state? My D1 will be going to be in the on state as long as my P side of D1 is more than the N side of my D1. But what is tied to the P side of my D1 is negative number. Okay, then what has to be my N side of my D1? It has to be less than my P side potential. As this is negative, what do you mean by less than this minus 1.7? Less than this minus 1.7 is all about minus 1.8, minus 1.9 and so on. Okay, if they are negative numbers, larger number is representing the smaller value, smaller number is representing the larger value. Okay, so my N side potential should be greater than this magnitude, that is 1.7. okay, of course with the polarity negative, then my D1 is said to be on. Okay, for example, my diode is being like this. Okay, please do understand, if this is plus and this is negative, no doubt that it is forward biased, no issue at all, because P side is connected to the plus and N side is connected to the negative, no problem. Okay. N side is connected to the positive and P side is connected to the negative, then it is reverse biased, no issue at all. Okay, issue comes when both the terminals are tied to positive voltages, then what is going to decide whether my diode is being on or off? This side potential is more, okay, then compared to this side potential is going to decide that this is going to be in the on state. Okay, when both are tied to the positive, then this is deciding, if this is more than this, then it is in the on state, otherwise it is in the off state. Okay, if both are negative, okay, then from the magnitude point of view, I am saying that from the magnitude point of view, okay, this side has to be more than this side for my diode to be in the on state. Please do understand, okay, when I am saying magnitude, no polarity is considered. Okay, so with respect to negative, larger number is representing a smaller value, smaller number is representing the larger value. So that is why when there are negative numbers that are tied to for P side and the N side, okay, larger in magnitude is going to decide which is going to be on, which is going to be off. Or you can say that my P side is always greater than the N side. Okay. For example, minus 10 is here, minus 5 here. Forward biased or reverse biased? Forward biased or reverse biased?
Reverse biased.
Reverse biased, because N side is more than the P side. Okay. Because minus 5 is more than the minus 10. Okay. Suppose if I am having minus 1 here. Okay. And minus 6 here. Forward biased or reverse biased?
Forward bias,
because P side is more than the N side. That's all. Okay. So if you are clear with this concept, that is more than enough. Okay. So that is more than enough. So now you tell me. For what value of my input, my D1 is going to be off. Okay, for my D1 to be on, this N side potential should be less than my P side potential. Okay, so consider a negative half cycle. Consider a negative half cycle. Okay, D2 is off. Okay, no problem. But my D1 is going to be on. My D1 is going to be off. Okay, when will be my D1 is going to be off? On. When my D1 is going to be off, only when my VI is greater than, VI is less than minus 1.7. Is this okay? When my VI is less than minus 1.7, less than minus 1.7 means minus 1.8, minus 1.9 and so on. Okay. My D1 is going to be off when my VI is greater than minus 1.7. Greater than minus 1.7 means minus 1.6, minus 1.5, minus 1.3 and so on. So forth. Okay. So this is what is the scenario. Okay. This is what is the scenario. Is this okay? Right. So for my negative input, DT is anyway off and my D1 is on or D1 is off is decided by whether my VI is less than minus 1.7 or VI is greater than minus 1.7. Okay. Right. So my VI is greater than minus 1.7. Suppose my 1.7 is somewhere here. Okay. Let me draw it like here. My 1.7 is here. This is negative. Okay. Negative minus 1.7. Okay. My 1.7 is here. Right. So my input less than minus 1.7. Input less than minus 1.7 means from where to where? If I am moving in this direction to this direction, my input is less than minus 1.7. Okay. If I am moving here, okay, my input is greater than minus 1.7. Okay. So for my input is less than minus 1.7, my D1 is on. When my D1 is on, D2 is off. What is my output is? D2 is off. You remove or you replace with open circuit. My output is minus 1.7 itself. So my output is minus 1.7 itself. Okay. So whenever my input is less than minus 1.7, my output is minus 1.7 itself. Okay. Right. So whenever my input is greater than 1.7, okay, what do you say about your D1 is
same.
D1 is off, D2 is off. That means output is same as the input. Okay, output is same as the input. Okay. Right. Even from here to here, it's same as it. Is this okay? Right. For my input greater than 2.27. For my input greater than 2.7, we have seen that my output is same as 2.7. Okay. For my input in between 2.7 to 0, my output is same as input. And for my input is less than negative, at the same time it is less than minus 1.7. Okay. Then D1 is on. That means my output is same as. Okay. My output is same as your minus 1.7. Okay. When it is greater than that, my D1 is off. Output is same as the input. Is this okay? So this is how we are going to plot the output response for the given input signal. Okay, right. So what is the key point here is for what range of your input signal, the state of the diodes are. And once you are known with the state of the diodes, finding the output voltage is not an issue. Okay, so knowing that what is D1 is on or off, D2 is on or off, you know what is your output is. Okay, and moreover, we have not worried about which state which is not being existing here. Okay, so during the course of time we will be able to find out the correct state of the diode and we need not worry about that whether it is going to exist or not. Okay, we need not worry to find out which state that does not exist. Okay, we will not come across with that particular state if it is not existing because we know how to analyze which diode is in the on state, which diode is in the off state. Is this okay? Right. So this is what is the analysis of one of the two level clipping circuit. Fine.
Okay, look at the board here. This is the circuit that is given. Okay, this is the circuit that is given. You are asked to find out the maximum output voltage and the minimum output voltage that can exist in this circuit when the input signal is 10 sin omega t. Okay, when the input signal is 10 sin omega t. I hope you have understood my question. The question is, you need to tell me what is the maximum output voltage and minimum output voltage that can exist for this given circuit if the input is 10 sin omega t. Okay, this is the question. This is also a great question given for triple E. Okay, and before we go ahead, suppose this 10 kilo ohm resistor is not there at all. Suppose this 10 kilo ohm resistor is not there. What is the maximum output voltage and minimum output voltage without any without doing anything?
Vi, yes, Justin.
No, no, no. Minimum. That means some number. Minimum. Minus 4 is the minimum and maximum
four.
Is?
4.
Maximum is 4. Okay. So if this resistor is not there, there is nothing to do. Please understand. Catch the point. Okay. If this resistor is not there, there is nothing to do with the problem. Okay. But there is a resistor. That is the catch here. Okay.
In gate questions, you can expect like this. Okay. What you have learned in the classroom is different and what is being asked is different. Okay. No one is going to tell you about that there is a resistor when there is a resistor here. Okay. When there is no resistor here, there is no meaning in giving this value of the R also. Okay. But because the resistor value is being given, undoubtedly a value of this resistor also has to be given. Okay. So preparing, adjusting the problem is very, very important.
Okay.
So now, please ensure that you are going to do this problem. How do you proceed? Forget about what is my maximum value, what is my minimum value. Just assume that if your task is to find the output response for the given input signal, draw the input signal, just like how we have proceeded here, consider the positive half cycle. If positive half cycle is, that means my input is positive. When my input is positive, identify that which diodes are going to be on or off and tell me the other diode is dependent on what value of your input signal. Okay, so I will draw the
input waveform. Okay, I will draw the input waveform.
Okay, so this is the input, okay,
and this is plus 10 volts, this is minus 10 volts, and you are starting from zero, right?
So how do I proceed? Okay, positive half cycle means my input is positive, okay? When once my input is positive, tell me which diode is being on, which diode is being off. Which diode is being on, which diode is being off. How do I say that my D1 is being off or on? My P side of the D1 is tied to the negative number, P side is connected to the negative, and the N side, if it is positive, automatically my N side of D1 is more than my P side, then automatically D1 is going to be off. Okay? So when once I consider my positive half cycle, my input is positive. If my input is positive, my D1 is off. Okay?
For my input is positive, D1 is off. Okay?
I need not look at what value of my input is. If my input is positive, that is enough. That is enough for my D1 to be off. Why? Because my P side of the D1 is tied to the negative. Okay? Always I have to look for whether my P side is more than my N side. When my N side is positive and my P side is negative, D1 is off. Okay, so D1 is being off. What do you say about your D2 either on or off? If my input is positive, okay, then your D2 is going to be on only when this P side potential is more than this so-called 4 volts. Because N side of D2 is tied to the 4 volts. Okay, so until my VI is okay, until my VI is less than 4 volts, my D2 is off. Okay, my D2 is going to be off. For my input is positive, please understand, for my input is positive, D1 is off, and that too until less than 4 volts, that is in between 0 to 4 volts. Okay, in between 0 to 4 volts. In between 0 to 4 volts, my diode input is going to be positive, so D1 is going to be off. When my D1 is off, when my VI is less than 4, D2 is off. When both are off, what is the output is? When both are off, what is the output is? Off means replace the open circuit. Off means replace the open circuit. So no current flows. Voltage drop because R is 0. So my output voltage is same as the input. Okay? Right? So in the positive half cycle, I have covered 0 to 4. Okay? I have covered 0 to 4. While being the positive input voltage, if I increase my input beyond 4 volts, okay, up to 10 volts, what is say about your state of your diode? My D1 is still off because input is positive. My D1 is off. What is say about your D2?
On.
D2 is on. Okay, D2 is on. If your D2 is on, okay, if your D2 is on, D1 is off, what is your output is?
4 voltage.
Plus 4 volts. Okay, so my output is given as plus 4 volts. Okay, my output is given as plus 4 volts. Right? Is this fine? Now let us consider negative half cycle. Okay, now let us consider negative half cycle. If once my input is negative, okay, let me consider a negative half cycle. If once my input is a negative half cycle, okay, then what do you say about your D2? If once my input is negative, that means my P side of D2 is going to be negative and my N side of my D2 is connected to the plus, that means D2 is going to be off. Irrespective of magnitude of your input, if once your input is negative, that is enough for confirming that your D2 is in the off state. Okay? So for my negative half cycle, D2 is going to be off. Okay? For my negative half cycle, D2 is going to be off. Is this okay? Right. What do you say about your D1 in the negative half cycle? In the negative half cycle, the input is negative. And when will your D1 is going to be on? When my P side is more than the N side. Okay, so that means what? In the negative half cycle, okay, when my VI is, okay, my P side is minus 4, so my N side has to be, my N side has to be less than minus 4. Less than minus 4 means minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 and so on. Okay, so when my VI, okay, when my VI which is tied to the N side is less than minus 4, then what is about your D1? D1 is in the on state. When my VI is greater than minus 4. Okay. When my VI is greater than minus 4. Greater than minus 4 means what? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 and so on. So when my N side, okay, which is connected to your VI, if it is greater than minus 4, that is minus 3, minus 2, 1, 0 and so on. My N side potential is more than my P side. That is why my D1 is going to be off. So my D1 is going to be off. Okay. My D1 is going to be off, right? So for VI is greater than minus 4 is no problem. My D1 is off, my D2 is off. What is my output is when both are being off? When both are being off, my output is same as the input. So no issue. Okay, so please understand. When my input is greater than minus 4, D1 is off and D2 is off. So my output is same as the input. So no issue. But from when my VI is less than minus 4, what is my D1 is on? D2 is off. When my D1 is on and D2 is off, what is your output is being given by? My D1 is on and D2 is off. Okay, let me replace with their equivalent representations. Okay, D1 is on and D2 is off. Okay, D2 is off and D1 is on. Okay, right, look at here. D1 is on, D2 is off. What is my output is given by? So now my output is no more very obvious. Okay. So my output is all dependent on find out what is my current that is flowing through your diode. Okay. In which direction the current is flowing. The current has to flow in accordance with the diode that is from P side to the N side. So that means current has to flow in this direction. Yes or no?
my D1 is N to P. So that means my current has to flow from P side to the N side. Okay, right? So you need to find the current that is flowing. Then your output voltage is given as, okay, minus 4 plus drop across this 10 kilo ohm resistor. That is what is being your output, okay, when D1 is on and D2 is off. Okay, that is what is being your output when D1 is on and D2 is being off. Okay, so can you find out that output? Okay, can you find out that output? So what is your I is being given by? Apply the KVL. Okay, so apply the KVL 10 into I, so that my I will be in the milliampere that I will be getting. Okay, so my 10 kilo ohms into I, if I is in the milliampere, milli kilo gets cancelled. So 10I plus 4, okay, 10I plus 4 plus 10I, okay, plus VI is equal to 0, right? So 10I plus 4 plus 10I plus VI is equal to 0. So what is my I is 20I plus VI plus 4 is equal to 0. So what is my I is given as? Okay. Right? So my I is given as minus of VI plus 4 whole divided by 20. Right? Okay. So under what condition that we got this I is equal to? We got this I is equal to when my D1 is on and D2 is off. Okay, right? See, once you know your I, okay, if I ask you to find out your output, can you find out your output? Yes, you can. So your output is minus 4 volts plus drop across this 10 kilo ohms. Okay, so for your output to be the maximum, is it not that your input has to be the maximum? Yes, your input has to be the maximum. Okay, for your output to be the minimum, your input has to be the minimum. Okay, so what is your output is going to be to be minimum. Okay, for my output to be minimum, my input has to be minimum. Okay, for my, let us say that, what is the minimum input voltage? The minimum input voltage is minus 10 volts. Okay, so replace your input with minus 10 volts. Okay, so when I replace my input with minus 10 volts, minus 10 plus 4 minus 6, minus into minus plus 6 plus 6 by 20 milliamperes. I told that 10 into I is in the milliampere. Okay, so when I replace my I with the minimum value, VI with minimum value, I will be getting the corresponding voltage as a minimum voltage. Okay, for my output voltage to be minimum, my input voltage has to be minimum. Okay, so the minimum input voltage is minus 10 volts. So minus 10 plus 4 is minus 6, minus into minus is plus 6, plus 6 by 2, 20. Okay, plus 6 by 20. Plus 6 by 20 is how much? Plus 6 by 20 is how much? 0.3. Okay, 6 by 2 is 3, by 10 is 0.3. So 0.3 milliampere. Okay, so my current is found to be 0.3 milliampere. Okay, so can you find your output now? Can you find your output now? My output is given as V0 is equal to, okay, my output is given as V0 is equal to minus 4 volts, okay, minus 4 volts. And when my current is in this direction, it is positive. When my current is in this direction, it is negative. So minus 0.3 into 10. So this is in milli, this is in kilo, both gets cancelled. Okay, right? So that is given as minus 4. 0.3 into 10 is 3. So that is minus 3. So it is minus 7 volts. Okay, so the minimum output voltage is going to be minus 7 volts. What is this is? Minimum. Why minimum? Because my input is minimum, I have considered. Okay, so the input minimum, input is minimum, output is also going to be minimum. Input is maximum, my output is going to be maximum. Okay. Okay, so look at here. So this is the problem that is given. What you are asked to find out is the transfer characteristics. Okay, what you are asked to find out is the transfer characteristics. What do you mean by transfer characteristics? Plotting the response, plotting the graph between input voltage and output voltage. And let your input voltage be varying up to 100, let us say, or maybe up to 500. Okay, let us say up to 500. Okay, so for your input varying from 0 to infinity, okay, for your input varying in between 0 to 500, then you try to understand what is your output. This is the question, okay, right? So please do understand carefully. Okay, so how do we proceed? Is the question is okay? Some circuit has been given to you, don't get afraid. First thing is, you should not get afraid, okay? And you are asked to plot the transfer characteristics. On x-axis, it is input. On y-axis, it is output. For different values of your input, you are asked to plot the transfer characteristics. Okay? Right? Okay. So, as this is the first problem, okay, looking like complicated, though it is not, okay, I'll do first. Then the next problem, you can do it yourself. Okay? Okay. So, let me start like this. Let my VI is less than 25 volts. Is this okay? My starting point. Okay? My starting point. I am assuming that my VI is less than 25. That means right from 0 to 25. My VI is greater than 0 but less than 25. Right? What do you say about your state of the diodes? What do you say about your D1 and what do you say about your D2? Anyone? If VI is less than 25 and
D1 is, off.
D1 is off.
Okay?
D1 off. Yes, very good. D1 off because my N side of my D1, okay, my N side of my D1 is tied to 25 and when my input is set to be less than 25, so naturally it is expected that D1 is tending to be off. Okay, so my D1 is off, right? My D1 is off. What do you say about your D2? To the P side, to the P side of my D2, 100 is connected, okay? And to the N side of my D2, roughly 25 is being connected, or my input is even less than 25. So at any cost, my D2 is going to be forward biased because my P side is connected to 100. Okay, so with my VI is less than 25, my P side of my D2 is always greater than my N side of my D2, so that my D2 is going to be on. Okay, so with my D1 off, okay, and D2 on, what is your output is being given by? D1 off and D2 on. Okay, let me draw the equivalent circuit. Okay, so what is my equivalent circuit? So my equivalent circuit is like this. Okay, my equivalent circuit is replacing your diode with open circuit and replacing my D2 with a short circuit. Okay, replacing my D2 with a short circuit and this is what is my output voltage. Okay, yes or no? This is my output. This is my 25. This is my 100. Okay, right? So what is my output voltage is given as? My output voltage is given as? My output voltage is given as a drop between these two. Yes or no? How do I find out the drop between these two? Find out the current that is flowing. How do I find the current? Whatever the current that is flowing, that should be in accordance with the D2. Okay? So the current that is flowing through D2 has to be from P side to the N side. So that is why I am saying that, okay, let this be flowing in this direction. Then you find out your I2 so that your output is being given by, okay, drop across this resistor plus 100 volts. Okay, can you find this I2? Yes, I can. Apply KVL. So minus 100 plus how much is this value? 200. Okay, this is 100. Okay, 200 I, right? And this is 100 I or I2. Plus 25 is equal to 0. Okay, plus 25 is equal to 0. Right? So, what is my I2 is given by? 300 I2 is equal to, okay, 300 I2 is equal to 100 minus 100 plus 25 is minus 75. When it goes to the right hand side, it is plus 75. I2 is equal to, I2 is equal to
0.25.
0.25 milliampere. Okay, 0.25 milliampere. Okay, right? Yes or no? Okay. So with I2 is equal to 0.25 milliampere, can you tell me what is your output is? from this node to this node is what is my output is. Okay, so I2 is in this direction, which is positive. When I come in this direction, it is negative. Okay, so my V out is given as, my V out is given as, okay, if my I2 is in this direction, it is positive. If I am considering in this direction, because I am finding out my output in this direction, so minus I2 into 200, so I2 is 0.25 into 100, 200 kilo ohms plus 100. So when this is minus 25 to 50, minus 50 plus 100 is plus 50. Okay, right? So my output is going to be plus 50. When your output is going to be plus 50? When your output is going to be plus 50? Until your input is less than 25, your output is going to be plus 50. Okay, please do understand carefully. Okay, my output is going to be plus 50 as long as your D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, so when my output here is plus 50, okay, when my output here is plus 50, is it not my output here is also plus 50? Yes. Okay, because both the nodes are at same. Okay, so this is nothing but your, okay, N side of your D1. Okay, this is nothing but your N side of your D1. Okay, so when my N side of the D1 is at 50 volts, okay, how long my D1 is going to be in the off state so that this output voltage is valid? How long my input voltage, how long my D1 is going to be in the off state with my N side is being given at 50 volts so that my output is being given by 50 volts. Whenever my input, whenever my D1 is off and D2 is on, I found my output to be 50. As long as your D1 is off, your output is holding to be 50. But how long your D1 is going to be off with your output as 50 at this node? This node is your N side of your D1. So until my input is 50, okay, or less than or equal to 50, your D1 is still in the off state. Yes or no? Not only 25, please do understand. Though I have considered at the initial time, my VI is less than 25, but even up to my VI is equal to 50, my D1 will be in the off state only. Okay, even up to my VI is equal to 50, my D1 continues to be in the off state only. Why? Because with my D1 off and D2 is on, I found this particular voltage to be 50, which is nothing but your N side of your D1. And for my D1 to be in the on state, my P side of D1 has to be more than the N side. That is, until my VI is less than or equal to 50, my D1 is in the off state, my output is going to be as 50. So that means instead of 25, I can vary up to 50, okay, so that my output is going to be 50, right? Initially, I don't know that point, okay? Initially, I don't know that point, but I have considered like VI is less than 25. Upon following with the equivalent circuit and finding the output voltage, I have confirmed that, okay, I can vary my input voltage up to 50 so that my D1 is going to be in the off state itself, so that my output is valid whatever I have calculated here as 50 volts. Is this okay? Right? So that is, in between 0 to 25, it has been changed to 0 to 50, where my D1 is going to be off, D2 is going to be on, for which my output is found out to be 50. Okay? Is this fine? Okay. Okay, so what is our conclusion is, when my VI is in between 0 to 50, my output is found out to be 50. Okay, my output is found out to be 50, right? So now let us increase my input from 50 to 100. Okay, from 50 to 100. Why I have considered as VI is less than 100? When my VI is less than 100, my D2 is still going to be in the on state. Yes or no? My positive side of my D2 is tied to the 100 volts. When I consider my VI is less than 100, I'll assume that my D2 is going to be still in the on state. Okay, still in the on state. But my D1 is now going to be, on state. Okay, because until my VI is less than or equal to 50 only, my D1 is going to be in the off state. Otherwise, it is going to be in the on state. So now my D1 is going to be on state and my D2 is going to be, okay, my D2 is going to be on state. Okay, so for this interval, let us assume that D1 is on and D2 is on. with D1 is on and D2 is on, this is short circuited, this is short circuited, what is your output is given by? My output from here to here is same as from here to here is same as from here to here. Yes or no? With my D1 on, D2 on, my output from here to here is same as from here to here is same as from here to here. So my output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input, right? Okay. So that is up to 100. Okay, that is up to 100. Okay, up to 100. What is my output is same as the input. Okay, what is my output is same as the input. So how do I represent from 50 to 100? Output is same as the input. Okay. So when my input is greater than 100, what is going to happen? When my input is greater than 100, what is going to happen? When my input is greater than 100, my D1 is said to be in
on
state. D1 is going to be in the on state. What do you say about your D2?
Off state.
Off state. When once D2 is off, you remove it. Okay. And from where to where you are looking at your output? You are looking at your output in between these two nodes. And what is your output is being given by? Upon replacing your
time.
D2 with? What is your output is?
Done.
What is your output is?
Done. 100.
That is 100. Okay. Right. I think it is not clear. It is 100 volts. Okay. It is 100 volts. That is why I have considered up to 100. Okay. So my output is going to be 100 when my VI is greater than 100. Okay. So my output is going to be 100. Okay. Okay, my output is going to be 100, right? Is this okay, drawing the transfer characteristics from an unknown circuit? We don't know anything about the circuit, okay? And that too, the diodes are not placed as per our learned circuit, okay? They were something in a different way that they are placed, but still we are comfortable in drawing the transfer characteristics. I am sure that if once you can draw the transfer characteristics, it is very easy for you to draw the output response also. Okay, so normally you will be asked to draw the transfer characteristics even in the examinations also. Is this okay? Right? So when we are at the initial stage, you can take your input voltage at some predetermined values. Okay, so you can see that what are the reference voltages that are given. Accordingly, you can go ahead in taking your input voltages. Okay, is this fine? This circuit is? Yes or no? From tomorrow onwards, we will be considering circuits which consists of more than two diodes. Okay, that means three diodes, four diodes. Even then, it will be very easy for to analyze the circuit. Okay, but for today, we will confine to one more two diode circuit. Okay, and the circuit is being given like this. So this is what is the circuit. Just try for a while so that we will continue now itself. Okay, just try for a while. What should be my first step is? My first step is, question is same, drawing the transfer characteristics. Okay. So what may be my first step is? VI is less than 25 volts. Okay. Why I am considering 25 volts only? Because I am seeing the smallest reference voltage to be somewhat like 25 volts. Okay. And the next larger reference voltage is 100. Okay. So let us see what happens if my input is less than 25 volts, because I have to increase my input voltage right from zero, okay, and then slowly I have to increase my input voltage. Okay, so when my VI is less than 25, tell me what are the state of your diode. Okay, what are the state of your diode when my VI is less than 25?
Off.
What is off? Both are off.
Both
are off. Okay, D1 is off and D2 is off. Okay, so why D2 is off? Because to the N side of my D2, 25 is connected, and to the P side of my D2, it is even less than 25, because my P side has to be more than my N side, my D2 is off. And to the N side of my D1, 100 volts is connected, so that when my input is less than 25, D1 is also going to be off. When both are off, what is my output is given by? This is off.
25 volts.
This is off, you replace with open circuit. This is off, you replace with open circuit. So my voltage in between these two is then given by 25 volts. Okay, so my output is going to be 25 volts. Okay, so what is my transfer characteristic for this? Okay, until 0 to 25, what is my output is going to be 25. Okay, the next interval is 25 to 100. What do you say about the state of the diodes? For 25 to 100, what is the state of the diodes?
D1 off, D2 on.
Okay, Vi is greater than 25. Vi is greater than 25, okay, but less than 100, so D1 is off. Okay, Vi is greater than 25, so naturally this D2 is going to be on. Okay, D2 is going to be on, right? So with the D1 off and D2 on, D1 off and D2 on, okay, let me draw the equivalent circuit. D1 off, or I'll not draw anything because D1 off means you are removing that. Okay, D2 is on. Okay, D2 is on. This is my output voltage, and it is 200, and it is 25, and it is 100. Okay. So what is the current that is flowing? As no current can flow through this because this is an open circuit. Okay. If at all a current is flowing, that has to flow in accordance with the diode D2. Okay. That has to flow in accordance with the diode D2. Okay. So can you find the output voltage now? For finding the output voltage, you need to find the current that is flowing through this. So that my drop across this plus 25 volts. So what is the current that is being given by? You just find out, okay, so that your output will be given in terms of input voltage. Okay, tell me what is your expression for I is given by. Okay, so I2 is equal to Vi minus 25 by 300. So this is in the milliampere. Okay, this is in the milliampere. Okay, right. So when once you know your I2, which is flowing in this direction, so what is your V0 is given by? My V0 is given as, my V0 is given as 200 into, okay, 200 into I2 is this, Vi minus 25 by 300 plus 25. Is this okay? We are trying to find out your output voltage over the interval 25 to 100. Where you see that your D1 is off and D2 is on. As long as your D1 is off and D2 is on, you could have your output voltage to be as 200 into Vi minus 25 by 300, where your Vi is varying in between 25 to 100. Okay, right? So your output is more or less dependent on your input. Okay, your output is dependent on your input, right? Okay, input range is greater than 25. Okay, and this relationship between the output and the input is holding good as long as your D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, as long as your D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, right. So tell me how long your D1 is going to be in the off state. How long your D1 is going to be in the off state. Okay, see what is the voltage I got. I got my voltage, which is given by this value. Okay. And this voltage is same as this particular voltage because D1, D2 is going to be in the on state. Yes or no? Please understand. Whatever the expression I got for my output voltage is same as at this node also because D2 is in the on state. Okay? Right? So this voltage is what is tied to your positive of your D1 and negative of your D1 is tied to your 100 volts. And tell me now how long your D1 is going to be in the on state. As long as your P side of your D1, that is your output voltage, what you have found out in terms of your input voltage, is greater than or equal to, is greater than your input 10, 100 volts, this D1 is going to be your on state. If your output voltage is less than or equal to 100 volts, then your D1 is said to be in the off state. Okay, and that means this particular thing, which is nothing but your output voltage, can go up to 100 for making your D1 still to be in the off state. When once your output is going beyond your 100 volts, then it is going to be in the on state. Then this particular relation between input and output is no more valid. Please do understand, okay? Whatever the expression we got, it is valid only when my D1 is off and D2 is on. You have to confirm now that what is the input range for which your D1 is going to be in the off state. Anyway, D2 is being on, that is okay. How long your D1 is going to be in the off state, okay? So as negative terminal of D1 is connected to plus 100, if my until my positive terminal of my D1 is less than, greater than or equal to 100, it is going to be in the off state, okay, right? So that means for my output to be 100, okay, for my output to be a maximum of 100, what should be the input? Please understand what we are doing. I would like to find out my input, okay, such that my D1 can still be in the off state, such that this particular output is going to hold good, right? So for my input variation, my this particular voltage, which is nothing but your output voltage, under your assumption that your D2 is on and D1 is off, okay, is going to be valid as long as this particular node voltage is less than or equal to 100, or at max it can have only 100. But if it is greater than 100, then only it is going to be in the on state. So let this be the maximum as 100. That means for my output to be the 100, what is going to be my input voltage? Okay. So far we have thought that until my input is less than 100, my D1 is going to be in the off and D2 is going to be the on. But that may not be true, because you just find out what is your output voltage to be 100. What is your input voltage? What is your input voltage for your output voltage to be 100? You tell me. How much for V0 is equal to 100? Vi is equal to how much? Just plug in V0 is equal to 100 and just find out what is your Vi. 137.5. Okay, right? So left hand side, V0 is 100, minus 25 is 75. This 100 gets cancelled. So 75 into 3, right, divided by 2, plus 25. Okay, so it's a matter of simplification. So what is that your conclusion is? Not only up to my 100, but even you can increase your input until 37.5 volts, so that this particular node voltage is going to be maximum of 100 only. Okay, only when your input is greater than 37.5, then only this particular node voltage, which is your output, is going to be more than 100, for which your diode D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, right? So that means your output is dependent on your state of the diodes. As long as your D1 is in the off and D2 is in the on, your output is being given by this. But once your D1 is now changing from off state to the on state, then this voltage is no more valid. That is what the point is. That is why you are trying to find out how long your D1 is going to be in the off state. This D1 is going to be in the off state as long as this particular P side of your D1 is not more than 100. Okay? As long as this particular voltage is not more than 100, your D1 is going to be in the off state. And once this voltage is greater than 100, then your D1 is going to be in the on state. Whatever you have done is no more valid. So for my output, which is at this particular node, to be at max 100, what is my input that I can go beyond that? Okay, so that input you found out to be 137.5. Okay, right? Okay, D1 off and D2 on, what is your output voltage is given as? D1 off and D2 on, what is the output voltage is given as? This voltage from here to here is same as this voltage, which is nothing but this voltage, because this is open. Okay, from here to here is same as here to here. So my output is same as input over the interval D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, right? So when once my input is greater than this 137.5, what is my state of the diode? D1 is on. Okay, and D2 is D2 to the negative of the D2, only 25 on. When both are on, what is your output is? output from here to here, this is on. Okay, output from here to here, when this is on, what is your output is? When you look at your output from here to here, is either the drop across this 200 kilo ohms plus 25, or it is same as the voltage from here to here when this diode is in the on state, that is 100. Okay. Even if you try to find out the current that is flowing and then you take the drop across this and 25, that is also same. Or you take it from these two points when this diode is in the on state, that is 100. Okay. So please to understand, okay, when D1 is off and D2 is on, this is what is the equation we got. You plug in different values of your VI, and until your VI is equal to 137.5, still your output is going to be remaining with the states D1 is off and D2 is on. Okay, when once your input is greater than 137.5, your D1 is on as well as your D2 is on. With the D2 is on and D1 is on, that means your output from here to here is 100. Your output from here to here is drop across this plus this. In either way, your output is found to be 100 only. Okay, right? Okay. Right? Is it okay now? So within this region, what are the states of my diodes?
Both are off.
Both are off. Within this region, what are the states of my diodes?
D1 off, D2 on.
Within this region, what are the states of my diodes?
Both are on.
Both are on. Okay. So D1 is off, D2 is off. Okay. Where my input is same as my output. Okay. So what are the states of diodes here? D1 is off and D2 is on. Here both are on. Okay. Right. So this is what is the problem is finding the transfer characteristics of the circuit. Fine. So today, so though the number of problems we covered are more in number, but nevertheless, because they belong to the similar category, we may not get that difficult to understand. Okay. So with this, we will be winding up the two-level clippers. In the next class, we will be starting the multi-level clipper. Okay. Where you could see the number of diodes more than two. Okay. Where you could see that the number of diodes more than two. Okay. Right. So, right.